Wednesday morning, push day. I'm gonna do chest press. I'm gonna start using that yellow band. I'm gonna start adding that in harder, deeper into the chest. Then we're gonna do crossovers, overhead press, triceps, and then double up on some legs, and then get on with the day. Let's go. All right. Take a little break, get some blood back in the chest, and then we're gonna go for the yellow band. Oh yeah. Oh, that definitely takes everything. Oh.
Just hold the stretch as long as you can. Oh my God. Big stretch at the end. Man, those bands really pull that chest wide. We got 8 with the yellow band after doing 30 on the black band. I guess probably what the program is gonna be is just hit my 30 with the black band, really tire the chest out, give it about 30, 40 seconds to get some feeling back in the chest, and then hit that yellow band hard as I can, because the intensity going from the black band to that yellow band, the intensity really ramps up. You really have to use everything to get that band, at least for me, to get that yellow band all the way out, and then continue with that lot more tension, a lot more. The black band is 300 doubled up, and the yellow band is 400 doubled up. So that's a good jump. I'm happy with that. So I'm gonna continue working that program. All right, so did the overhead press with the wide bar, and I grabbed it right where the knurling is. And is that, that's actually the farthest out on the short bar, that's where my hands would be. The difference with this is, because it's a longer bar, those bands give you a lot more tension. So as you push it over your head, that band is really rocking. And then these are out farther, so you're not getting the bands resting across your forearm like you do with the shorter one. As you're going up, the band is going across that forearm, which is giving you more stability, so you're not rocking. Doing it this way, you're getting a lot more rocking as you're going up. Instability and really makes your shoulders fire twice as hard. Once you start getting that instability, you're really just using all those stabilizer muscles and everything to push and keep it stable as you're going up. So I really like going to the inside of the bar with the wide bar and then doing the shoulder presses that way, because this instability is just so awesome. Whew. Stretch. Let it pull and stretch. Stretch. Oh my God. Alright. Alright, so I press down, double up black band. Just trying to keep those elbows locked in and just using that tricep much as you can before the chest comes in. And then use a white band behind the head. Just trying to, at that point, finish it off, the blood into the tricep, and just letting it stretch, pull. At the end, just let it pull down as far as you can. You can feel it stretching all inside here. Triceps got a good workout. Of course, they got that with chest press also, and overhead press. That's why I do my triceps at the end, because your triceps are used for all those movements. For your chest press, your triceps being used. Overhead press, your triceps being used. Not as much as your shoulders, but it's still being used to straighten that arm up. So you're pre-tiring your triceps out before you get to this press down at the end. If I was to do this one first, I could get a lot more reps. Just like if I was to do shoulder press first, I'd get a lot more reps. But your biggest muscle group is your chest, and all those other muscles are incorporated into using your chest. So I want to tire this out first. I don't want my small muscle groups, my shoulders and my triceps, to be tired first by doing overhead presses, press downs, and then do chest, because then your chest, your shoulders and your triceps will give out before your chest does. So that's why I'm hitting the chest three times now with the black band, the yellow band, then the crossovers in the end, and then a big stretch at the end of it just to let that sucker just really stretch wide, hyperplasia right at the end. And then you go into shoulders. Those are a smaller muscle group. Your chest is still incorporated, but not a whole lot. And your tricep is on that, so your tricep's being used. So after you're done with that, then you're gonna do the tricep press at the end, which these muscles have already been worked. So now your tricep actually has to work a whole lot more because these ones are already tired. So that's my theory, and that's why I do it the way I do it. Oh, 16. So, using a yoga block. to stand on, which is soft and wobbly and unstable. So once you start getting tired, all your weaker muscles want to give in, but you really have to focus hard, because then that becomes unstable the more tired you get, and really making all those leg muscles fire hard. Why did I do that? Instability really, really makes it so much harder. Anything you can do to make it unstable, do it. It makes your muscles fire so much harder. At 12 with the front squat, heels elevated, light gray band, and then try to do a big stretch at the end as much as I can. because those are really, really cramping up. All right, I take a few seconds to compile my thoughts after that. All right, so today, Wednesday, push day. I started off with 30 on the black band, chest press with the small bar, with the regular bar. And I think that's right about the good rep pace that I want, is just get to that 30 mark, which is really starting to actually get to the full range of motion. It's really starting to hamper. So chest fully full of blood, ready to go. Drop that down and then pick up the yellow band, which is 400 pounds of tension, and then just rep those out as hard as I can, because now my chest is really warmed up and it's ready to go, and I can hit, I got 8 reps with that, so now I can only obviously try and go farther with the yellow band. I think once, if I could do 30 and then 15 with the yellow band, then I would just switch over to doing the yellow band the whole time. So that's kind of my thought process here on this, is use the black band to get the blood pumping, to get that feel of the adrenaline rolling, and then switch it over to that yellow band, which really gets the adrenaline rolling, because once you hit that sucker for the first push out, man, you are using everything you can at my strength level right now, currently. And then going over to the long bar overhead press and doing close to the knurls right here, which if you look at the short bar, it's right in line with where your hands would be basically on the short bar. So your hands are like where you have with the short bar, but what this does is it's longer, so it creates that instability. And then with the short bar, those bands tend to come up and over your arm. So as you're coming up, you're using your forearms to really push that band back. So there's not much for instability with the short band. I could tell that a long time ago, that you're just using your arms once you hit that band, and you're widening your arms out, and you're really using your arms to push the band. When you go with the longer bar and you're doing the same thing, you're not using your forearms to push that band out. That band is free the whole time, so it's really rocking back and forth while you're going back there, and it's making everything fire big time. So I like that. Obviously my reps have gone down because obviously the long bar and the short bar takes up more band, and this takes up less band. So obviously I'm not a science major or anything like that, but obviously I'm taking up more space, more volume of the band with this bar. So it's gonna be a little bit harder. So I'm not sure what the tension level is with the light gray band with the long bar, but it's a little bit more than obviously with the short bar and overhead press. Tricep press down, just going with the black band, doubled up, I like that. Once I can get it up over my shoulder, especially with no shirt on, that band tends to stick when I can get it in the right spot. And it's just a matter of keeping your elbows locked in and just using your triceps to just press down. And then once you get to the point, obviously, where you can't do it no more, throw that off, get over to the white band, step on the white band, bring it up behind your head, and then just do those old dumbbell presses behind your head when you sit in the gym with the 40 or 50, or sometimes I would use the 80-pound dumbbell, and I would do the dumbbell presses behind your head. This is the same thing. And you're just finishing that out, and then at the end you just let that stretch, let that band really pull it down. You really could feel the stretch on the back of the tricep. I like that. And then I've been thinking about switching over to the lunges with the yoga block for the instability, and I just decided today to start doing it. That really adds to the instability of that foot. My right foot is a little bit more unstable than my left for some reason. Maybe has to do with the hip, my right hip still. I don't have my major issues there, but I still work on that, those hip flexor muscles, keeping those things working and firing and loose. But that instability, once you start getting tired, all those small muscles really start getting tired. You really got to act those, get those really active to really keep that stability and keep that slow momentum going up and down. So it really, really tires that quad out really quick. And then finishing off with the front squats. I like those. Those are really, really burning. I'm working on more flexibility so I can get where my heels aren't up no more. But that's gonna be a long time in motion, because I am 56 and I never did walk around or sit around in that squat position any part of my life.
So just getting the ankle flexibility to do that is just gonna be a continual journey that hopefully someday I'll be able to get there and do just flat-footed front squats like that. Until then, heels up just as good. You're still working those quads and I can feel them at the end. My legs are just freaking shaking like crazy. And then obviously go right into a quad stretch right after it. Throw the bar down. I use the block behind my back to kind of give me a little bit of a brace once I hit that maximum stretch, because your quads are so full of blood at that point and they hurt. And I don't want to really pull any ligaments or anything, but I want to get a good stretch at the end. So I did that stretch, catching my breath, rolling things up right now. I'm gonna pack everything into the bag, and then I'm going to do my 10 vacuums, 5 over the bench, and then 5 sitting down, cross-legged, and I get my vacuums out of the way. Always do your vacuums after you work out. Your core is so much engaged in doing all this, and so you don't need to do crunches, you don't need to do any of those exercises. Just do vacuum, work on sucking that muscle in, the transverse abdominis, the side muscles, your inside muscles for your stomach. You're really working on just pulling those in and really accenting all the other muscles that are working during all these workouts. So I like doing the vacuums afterwards. So I'm gonna get it, and then I'm gonna get on with my life because I got it done. See you tomorrow for pull day. One. Ten. Last one. And like on all of them, I just want to try and pull that belly button all the way to the back to the spine. Blow all your air out, about 90% of it, and just suck that in as hard as you can and just pull it back as far as you can and just hold it tight. I swear to God, you're going to start feeling it. Oh, you're going to start feeling it during the day. Later on in the day, you'll feel those muscles tightening up when you move. It's like, oh yeah, I did do something. They're not going to be sore. They're just going to feel like they were worked. I get rid of all this stuff and I'm gonna have me nice shape here. That's what I'm going for.